Everyone, my name is Anna from Toronto Public Library, and welcome to Mini Makers at Home. Mini Makers at Home is an online library program where each week kids and families will explore STEM concepts through fun hands-on activities. STEM is short for science, technology, engineering, and math. Learning about STEM is really important because these concepts are all around us and help us discover, explore, and innovate. And STEM can be really fun too. For today's challenge, we'll be creating straw rockets and learning about the physics of motion. Summer is a great time of year for stargazing, but sometimes when you're looking up at the night sky, you see a light that appears to be moving very slowly. These lights are often satellites circling our planet in orbit. They orbit our Earth, collecting information about weather patterns, geographic features like glaciers, and information about space. But how do satellites get up into space anyways? Through a rocket. Zoom! A rocket is a flying device that burns fuel to create enough energy to push itself into space. When fuel burns, it creates hot gases that are released from its engine as exhaust. When this exhaust is released, it pushes down on the ground. This push downward is called an action force, and it causes the rocket to move upward in an opposite direction. This is called a reaction force. Today's STEM challenge explores these two forces that act opposite to one another. Another way that you can see them in action is by sitting on a wheelchair and pushing against a wall. Be sure to ask a grown-up if it's okay to test this out. Even though you pushed against the wall, you moved away from it. That's because for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. This is called Newton's third law of physics, and it can be a super fun one. Whee! Engineers developing new rockets need to think of ways to control the rocket's speed, accuracy, and ability to fly long distances. They do this by changing variables on a rocket. A variable is a feature that can be changed, such as fin size, the number of fins, the shape, and the angles of the rocket design. By changing one variable at a time, engineers can determine if that change leads to an improvement in the performance of the rocket. Other factors that affect a rocket's success in getting into space are drag, gravity, and weight. Drag is a resistance force that can slow a rocket down. Gravity is a force pulling the rocket down toward the Earth. And the more a rocket weighs, the more force is needed for liftoff. The lighter a rocket is, the less drag it has, and the further and faster it will go, and the easier it will be to get into Earth's orbit. For this week, we are going to build a straw rocket. And you will see the physics of motion in action. So let's get started. For this activity, you will need paper, scissors, clear tape or a glue stick, straws, a ruler or measuring tape, pencil, and markers, crayons, or pencil crayons to decorate your rocket. Using these materials, we will build a straw rocket. We will begin by measuring a strip of paper that is 2 inches by 4 inches in size, and cutting it out of paper. You can use your markers, crayons, or pencil crayons to decorate this strip of paper as it will be the body of your rocket. Next, roll the strip of paper loosely around the straw lengthwise. If your straw and pencil are around the same width, you can also roll the paper around your pencil. Tape the paper roll along the long edge to secure the tube shape. This may be a little tricky to hold and tape together, so you may want to work together with your grown-up. Remember to keep your paper tube a little loose around your straw. If you roll it too tightly, there will be too much friction between the paper and the straw, and your rocket will not launch. Once you've secured your paper tube around your straw, use the sharpened end of the pencil to twist the top of the rocket body into a nose cone. Be careful not to jab yourself as you do this step. Many rockets have fins to help them stay on course and soar smoothly through the air. Fins provide stability as a rocket moves through the air very quickly. You can add fins to your rocket by measuring a square 2 inches by 2 inches, then drawing a line from one corner to the opposite corner so that you end up with 4 triangles. You don't have to add fins to your rocket if you don't want to, but if you do, don't forget to decorate your fins before you cut them out. This will create your fin shapes for your rocket. You can add them on with tape or glue. Be sure to place your fins on opposite sides of your rocket so they work together to add stability to your ship. Now on to the fun part. You get to test your rocket. Before you begin, check with your grown-up to find a safe place to launch your rocket. And remember, safety first. Never point your rocket at another person. When you are ready to launch, place your rocket on your straw and take a deep breath. 3, 2, 1, blast off! What did you see? Did your rocket go far? You can change the variables of your rocket or make many different rockets to test out. You can make rockets with one fin. You can make a rocket with no fins at all. You can make one with a cone tip or with a flat tip, one that is tightly wrapped around the straw, or one that is even more loosely wrapped around your straw. You can also experiment with different straw types like milkshake straws, silicone straws, or metal straws. Try making your own chart at home to track how changing each of these variables affects your straw rocket. I made one here to show you. There's a column where I can describe the type of rocket I am launching, like so. And another column where I can record all of the distance that each rocket traveled. You can try this too. As you launch your rocket multiple times, use measuring tape or a ruler to record how far it travels during each launch. Earlier, we talked about weight and shape as different variables that engineers consider when designing a rocket. Try adding some weight, such as cotton balls, to your rocket. How does it affect its performance? You can also experiment with different rocket shapes or fin sizes to test out new designs. Parents and caregivers, you play an important role in supporting your child's learning by participating and engaging with them in everyday activities. I hope you enjoyed today's Mini Makers at Home program. Check back soon for more Toronto Public Library Mini Makers at Home programs. Bye for now!